Hi, Scorpio. Welcome to your February mid-month reading. I am Lorianne, your intuitive guidance counselor, psychic medium, here to give you all the messages that I receive for the remaining time of February. So this is a mid-month for the sun, moon, and rising sign of Scorpio. Also, we are going to look at family, friends, career, finance, educate. Any message I get, I will relate to you. And take from the reading what is actually applicable in your life and let go of the rest, because you don't need it if it doesn't belong to you, right? Okay, so, wow, Scorpio, oh my goodness, okay. Beautiful. So we start off with you, the Tower. This is representing Scorpio, but the Tower is a change that's getting ready to take place in your life. If it didn't just happen, I'm talking before, just recently, before the 15th, it will happen over the next couple of weeks. Some of you, it could run into the first week of March is what I'm seeing. So this is a change in your world, a change in your life, a change in the way you view things, beliefs in your life. Does not mean it's negative. And the reason I'm saying that is we have the Fool card right next to it. Whatever's going to take place in your life that is going to equal newness coming in is going to be absolutely incredible for you. Let go, let things flow exactly the way they're meant to flow. We look at change as one of the most difficult things for us to do as human beings, but change is what really opens us up to say, whatever you got coming for me, I'm gonna take it. I'm gonna take it and look at it from a different angle, because this is your brand new beginning. This change that's gonna take place is gonna lead you to a very, very positive outcome. For some of you, I'm seeing like this rebirth inside of you. It could actually be a completion, a step in your personal transformation of what you're trying to accomplish in your life. The changes that are holding you back need to be made, okay? And that's what I'm hearing. Letting go of the old, allowing the new to come in. And oh my goodness, the rest of the cards are beautiful. So let's take a look at the detail before I continue. I want to see if this is in work, what area of life this is in. Let's see what the Tower is going to tell us here. Okay. For some of you, it is most definitely about money. You've been doing a lot in your career sector with your finances. You've been working really, really hard. And what I'm being shown is you've been doing the same thing over and over again, expecting different results. You're gonna have this aha moment for those of you where this is applicable, where you've been trying to get your finances in order, trying to get your education completed, and you've had all these bumps in the road. It's almost like I see you, because you are a fixed sign like I am. I'm an Aquarius. So we don't want the change, although we are very well aware that it can bring positive results, and that's what's going to take place. You feel a little bit worn out, like everything I'm doing isn't getting me to where I want to go. But this change, this aha moment, is going to take place, and it's really going to propel you forward into what you're meant to do, what you really love to do. So some of you are in a situation where you're going to class, taking classes that are making you feel bored. The Four of Swords, a sense of boredom. But this is also about healing within, because this is not just finances. For some of you, this is also about love. Now, we have a situation where some of you are dealing with a soulmate on a love, romantic level. You may have encountered this soulmate and they may be coming back. They're coming back to tell you, and I say coming back for a reason. They're literally coming back. You have amazing cards, all new areas of your life. This is about abundance. This is about following your true passion. What you truly want in life is getting ready to come to you. This brand new beginning, the Pentacles represents everything on the material plane. So the universe is saying, let go and allow this to take place in your life. It is going to lead you to an amazing new beginning in your life. the healing that you've gone through in a romantic relationship when it comes to, especially to your current partner, to somebody that you've been in a partnership with, romantically, there is a lot of healing that has taken place between you and another person where you're actually able to have a second go around with this person. When I say a second go around, starting a new beginning within the relationship that you're in, it's very lovely energy. For another group of you, you have a person coming back from the past. You're tired, you're worn out, you put in everything you could into this relationship, and you may have felt like you didn't get a whole lot back. So I see that you retreated and you began to focus on you, on your life. What is good for you? What isn't good for you? Removing the negative aspects of what's taken place and allowing the new to come in. And those of you who have been resisting, don't resist it. Let it happen. It's going to lead you. I mean, this is amazing, amazing cards for you guys. Now, when it comes to this career opportunity, most definitely some of you have a new partnership coming in. And when I say partnership, this is an actual business where you may have been approached in the past by somebody that has given you an opportunity that I don't see you took it yet. Now, this opportunity, this offer to start this new business venture is going to lead you to abundance, to following your passion, to prosperity. It's going to lead you in the direction you want to go. It's almost like with these cards, whatever change is going to take place. And again, very important that you hear this message, and I will repeat it again. The change is going to happen. Major arcana, that means the universe is coming in and they're going to make some changes, and it may feel a little bit difficult, like, oh my God, again, but allow it to come through, because that is the key. That's the key lesson for this group of you. The lesson is to not control the outcome, to allow things to flow naturally. And when we do, bam, everything starts brand new, leading us in a whole beautiful new direction. Love this energy. Now, this is not only is this new business venture going to really give you an emotional, like you're super happy about it. You love what you do. It's going to satisfy you on every single level and bring in the money that you want. For those of you where this is a soulmate returning, I see that there may have been, it's going to throw you for a loop because you are not expecting it. Yeah, here's the communication coming in. So this communication coming in, this message, this Page of Swords is a message coming in. You're going to receive this, and I think they're going to tell you that they're going to tell you that they love you. All right. Now, this is what I want for you guys to understand. It is very scary when we meet somebody where we have this intense connection for two reasons. One, they're familiar to us. So is this a repetitive cycle? We have a fear. Well, you're just like so-and-so, you're just like so-and-so. But that's because we haven't cleared and healed our own energy, letting go of our own past. Now, this coming into you is taking a lot of courage for them to step up to the plate and say, I was wrong. I am going to speak my truth to you. It is going to come out a little bit immature because they're afraid. It's hard to say, I love you. For many people in our world, when we've been through relationship after relationship and it fails, it doesn't matter if it was a 5-month relationship or 25-year relationship, we feel a sense of failure that is associated with the parting of the ways. And some of us feel victorious, but there is still a portion where I have to do this again. I don't want to do this again. And that's where they were at. And that can be vice versa because it is a general reading. Now, they may have been looking at you on social media. Definitely, when it comes to the career sector, they have been watching you. So if you have not been approached, some of you are going to be approached while you're putting energy and effort into your own finances again. Now, this other person coming in, this person, whether it be your current partner, They want to put, or the soulmate returning, they want to put the energy and effort in to start a new beginning with you. They see you as their perfect match, as the perfect fit. Oh yeah, they do. They see you as confident and strong, able to, so much charisma, so much beautiful character in you, where you can just take in a social setting, draw people to you. That's how they see you. That's a really beautiful energy. So they've been analyzing you, watching you put energy and effort into your work. For those of you where you have this opportunity coming in, that's why they're going to offer it to you. They like your style. They like what you do. They want to offer you this opportunity. So really think about this, because it can definitely move you forward. And the universe wants you to let go of all the negative aspects too. Your finances and career, but also in love. This person coming back from the past, and it can be for those of you where it's a current partner, there may have been a lot of turbulence between the two of you, a lot of arguing, lack of communication, not being on the same page. And you're letting go of it, and the universe is pushing you forward to do exactly that. They also are going to help your partner, and that's why they are analyzing this. Do I want to put the energy and effort in to create this amazing brand new beginning? For some of you, you may be finding out you're going to have a baby or a grandbaby coming in. This is going to be beautiful energy as well. Whether this is about career, whether this is about finances, education, or love, this is going to take a lot of strength and courage for you to allow this to unfold. And everything about this reading is saying, let go, let God. You have the strength and the courage to let things flow naturally. And when you do, and you use your inner wisdom, using your psychic abilities, you really, using your intuition, okay? Go with your gut. This is gonna be beautiful. I can't tell you how much this reading is all positive. Coming out of negative, like you've been through a lot of negative shit, and now it's coming to fruition in a positive movement. Now, again, this is a new venture coming in, and it's important to allow the universe to do its thing for you, and it's going to lead you in a very beautiful direction. So we are looking at Libra, Gemini, Aquarius, Leo. We're looking at every zodiac sign here. All the energies of fire, earth, water, and air, plus all the energies of each zodiac sign. Okay, so let's take a look at your romance angel card for the month. Next 2 weeks. I don't usually do mid-month readings for a reason, but because I'm not doing personal, I thought it'd be really super nice if, okay, you got two cards. So you have, it is safe for you to love. Open your heart to give and receive the highest energy of all. Now, this just not just for love itself, love of family, love of your romantic partner. This is about love of you. When we trust and love ourselves first, we know what's coming is meant for us to come. So it is safe for you to love. Open up, and it can lead you to engagement. Your love life is ascending to a higher level of commitment. For those of you where this is an opportunity going to come through on a financial, on a career sector, it is going to propel you forward. So it's going to lead to where some of you are going to sign a contract with this company, with this organization. You're going to come into partnership, and it is going to be very, very beneficial for you. And when we're talking about love, romantic love, this is again about you and your partner being able to reignite the love you have for each other. Maybe that starts on Valentine's Day and moves forward. Moving your relationship into a brand new beginning, okay? And for those of you where it is a person from the past returning, this is meant for you to be with this person. It's up to you for free will. We have free will. But if you allow things to flow naturally, it's going to be absolutely amazing. So I hope you have a wonderful next 2 weeks. Thank you for watching and much love.